three prayer points I can never forget in life. And I want us to pray them. The very first prayer point he gave to me, said, my son, pray that you will not have any, that you will not have any reason that will make you to be hiding from your mates. You will cry to your God and say, I refuse to hide from my mates, whatever level in life. I will never hide from my own mates. In Jesus' name we pray. The second prayer point he gave to me, he started with an illustration. And he said to my son, have you not seen people that were very successful in the class, but never successful in life? And I know what I left the school with. He gave me two practical examples back there in Nigeria. He said, well, listen, you can't let the University of Ibadan with what? And the University of Ibadan with what? A failure in the classroom is not a success in life. Let's clarify, I mean, left the dead pastor of Ephraim with what? He will cry to the Lord God to make you a success in life. Success in life. Success in life.
Father, in life.
Make you to be successful in life. Holy God, spiritual, ministerial, professional, help me to be successful. That time I was not even engaged into any marital relationship, let alone getting married. And I asked him, what's the prayer point? He said, it's a prayer of insurance. It's a prayer of investment. What's the prayer point? Only for me to hear it echoed audibly into my ear. Pray that the success of your children will be faster than your own.
Amen.
Want to go to your word again?
And we pray that the scriptures will be open to us.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Let me sit there, please. This morning by His grace, I want to provoke our hearts. You know what? One thing I know and I'm very sure of is this. The church of God can be better than this.
That's right.
And if God wants to do anything, He won't send angels to come and do it.
That's right.
It's we human beings that God will employ and do His work. If there is anything I've prayed and I'm still praying about, I don't want to enter that heaven like the thief on the cross, the one that sneaked to heaven. Eventually made heaven. But on the day of reward, he will be busy clapping for as many that will be receiving their rewards. I look at this church. We have nothing less than 30 matured adults that are here now. If all of us can go ahead between now and December and say, in a month we will win one soul. In a month we will win one soul. Which means at the end of the year, each of us that is able to score 12-12 will have reproduced himself and made it 13. Abby? Look at it, anytime you dream and you are not happy with the dream, you will wake up, you will pray. Use the name of the Lord Jesus to counter it. Anytime there is any revelation against you that somebody has told you, use the name of the Lord Jesus to destroy it. But what of those that are yet to know about Christ? Look at the way they are wasting away in the time. You think everybody here in the UK is enjoying? Go to where some people are sleeping. And I believe that all these tears can be filled. I have a question for you. The question is on the screen. How old are you? How old? Look at that. So teach us to number our days that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Some years ago, I was reading through the scriptures and I stumbled on this verse of the scriptures. And the Lord was asking me these questions more than 20 or 25 years now. The Lord asked me, how old are you? How old are you? I'm asking you, how old are you? Ask the next person that question, how old are you? In Africa, people don't normally like to declare their age. But whether you want to declare that your age or not, I have few standing facts I want to submit here this morning. Do you know that you have an appointment with death? Among every other thing in this world, it's only death that is certain. When a child is born, you don't know whether he will lead up to university level or not. You don't know whether he will be rich or poor. But you are very sure of one thing. What is that? You will die one day. How old are you? I'm married at the age of 32. When I clocked 35, I went to my wife and said, yeah, the Bible says we have 3 score and 10 numbers. If by grace we can get to 80, 100, 120, or whichever one. But if your husband, the son of man, is going to die at 70, now that he's already 35, it means that he has spent half of his life. When I clocked 40, I did the same thing. When I clocked 45, I did the same thing. A few years ago, I clocked 50. And I did the same thing. I look at my eyes and if your husband is going to die at 70, he's already playing the second half of the game. So teach us to number our days. Look at what I put there. I said, how old are you and how many more years do you have before meeting God? The fact that you don't know is not a reason to be serious with God. I want to ask Father, who is the nearest to the grave among us here? Who will die here that will not get his meat either in hell or heaven? Sincerely speaking, the way many of us are living our lives is as if we have 1,001 years to live. I know many of us will be saying this is redeemed to the church of God and his covenant of long life in this. So it's true. But where was God when Abel died? The youngest in the family of Adam and Eve, the one that gave God the most quality offering that has now become point of reference for we ministers. Where was God when that one died? If there was anyone I expected God to have protected, it should be that boy. Where was God when Cain, his brother, slain him? Where was God when his only begotten son was crying on the cross, my father, why have you now forsaken me? Any response? Do you think he will love you more than his own son? And I went forward and said, my simple research into biographies of many popular hymn writers revealed a lot of things. Look at it. Anytime you want to have Holy Communion or baptismal program, there is a song we like to sing. Oh, happy day when fix my joys on thee, my Savior and my God, when it is glowing and rejoice and tell it all raptors abroad. Happy day, happy day when Jesus washed my sins away. He taught me how to watch and pray, and then rejoice in every day. Happy day, happy day when Jesus washed my sins away. Billy Dudridge, the one that wrote that song, died at 29. Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, you know that song. Holy, holy, holy. The one that wrote it, Reginald Heber, died at what age? 43. We love to sing, nearer my God to thee, nearer to the Sarah Flower than the one that wrote it. Passed on to glory after marking at 33. Take my life and let it be consecrated, Lord, to thee. Take my moment and my day, let them flow. Francis Peter Parker, the one that wrote it, died at 43. You know one thing about death, it doesn't take it chronologically. If to say that death is killing people according to our age, the moment I enter into this auditorium, I will have some program to know when it will come to my senior number to go. But death is so callous, so disrespectful, it can go to anybody at any time. Supposing this is the year, because people don't normally like to hear it at all.
That's
what do you want to be remembered for here on earth and be rewarded for in heaven? I would see, the Rock of Ages left for me, died at 35. And I said, why do we not to count our days? We have only one life. Hebrews 9:27, it is appointed unto men once to die. But after this what? And this only one life you have doesn't have any duplicate copy. When we die, we don't return here. Therefore, whatever you want to do for God, because many people believe that when, thank God, I was missing our pastor for the very first time today, and we were three inside the vehicle that came to carry me. We couldn't discuss any private thing. He didn't send me to you. Because I know many people might be thinking, did pastor discuss anything with this man? No! With God that is sending me to you, that this year you should live it better than the way you have been living other years.
Amen.
Look at, I said, when will that be done it on here?
James 4:13, go to now. Ye that say today or tomorrow will be going to such a city and continue there a year and buy and sell and get gain.
Whereas you know not what shall be on the morrow. For what is your life? It is even a paper that appeareth a little while, then vanishes away.
Boast not yourself of tomorrow.
Why?
You don't know what tomorrow will bring.
You don't know what tomorrow will bring. I said we are closer to our grave this year than last year.
That's right.
At times when I see people celebrating their birthday and they are saying they are a year older, in them, what is the heavenly saying? A year is subtracted. Someone that will die at 70 and is celebrating 69th birthday. In heaven, what are they saying?
Hurry up.
Hurry up! Because when we are saying the year is added here, they are saying the year is subtracted in heaven.
Look at what happened here. I said, we are not growing younger. Go and look at a picture. Snapped. This year or last year, compared with that of 10 years ago. What is happening?
I said, in your journey through life,
do what?
Stop and think.
Stop
and think.
Why? Are you aware that all this macros in life, one day we cease. Oh, I want to have this, I want to have that. I was telling someone, a friend was telling me, while we were discussing, he struggled to get his own PhD. He said, bro, Joel, when they gave him this PhD, you know what? The whole result was on one page. What he labored for. On how many pages? One page.
In a paper.
And reading through the whole page. Are you aware that all these madros we see? And everything in that your house will become quiet. Oh, my office. One day that office will become vacant. Whatever you want to do for God, do it now. A day is coming where that bed will become very, very cold. And your food will be left on it. Your water will remain inside the cup. And your shoes, what? They may not size your children. Your shirts, skirt, blouses, and trousers will now remain on hunger. And your car will be unstarted. The day is coming when the TV, video, CNN will be unwatched. Do you know that there are some clothes one will buy and never use? That's why. The day is coming when they will call your phone or call my phone. And what we have? There will be no answer. Before the battery will run downstairs, since nobody will be there to charge it. Therefore, whatever you want to do for God, start now. If I can ask you, supposing this is the year, the casket is brought to the church. And choristers are singing. Fading away like a stars of the morning. Losing their lights in the glory of song. Those we who pass from this world and its toils only remember by what we have done. Only remember by what we have done. Those we who pass from this world and friends.
September last year, one of my friends, the coordinator of the country in Europe, yeah. 2016, we were together. He invited me. And I had a tea pastor. I could not go when they were to bury him. I was watching everything. I saw the way they carry my friend. When the funeral service ended in the church, he journeyed to the cemetery. I was looking at this man. The chorister sang, "This world is not my home. I'm just a passing through. My treasures are laid up somewhere on the way. The angels may come from heaven's throne, Lord, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know that I have no friends like you. And if heaven is not my home, then Lord, what will I do? In this part of the world, many people think that when they are doing well in the church, it's the pastor they are helping. It's happening in Africa today. We beg and beg and beg. Whatever you want to do for God, I am begging you. You are only crediting your account in heaven. You are not helping anyone. You are not helping your pastor. Truth may be bitter, it may be tough, hard, and at times annoying. But one fact always remains about the truth, is imperishable.
That's right.
Some, as brilliant as they are, they will calculate their tithes, they will never be able to get correct answer. Thinking that they are helping pastor. Can you see? Supposing this is the day. This is the year. Because there is a year you enter, never enter another one. Or you've never realized that. You've never thought along that direction. And there is a month ahead of you when 30 days will be too much for you to finish. A week is ahead of your life when 7 days you will not be able to exhaust. And a day is ahead when 24 hours will be too much. And that's why they will ask, when did he die? 5 p.m. 4 a.m. My brothers and sisters, how old are you? If I'm in my 50s, children at home normally ask me, "Daddy, why are you restless?" I say, "I don't think I have another 50. I'm not very sure of another 40. Therefore, those of us that are still younger, if there is any time you need to work for God, please let it be now. I said, a day is coming when your letters will be unclaimed. We deploy one missionary after finishing from our college to a place called Bonny Island in Nigeria. This brother got here. The wife refused to join for a period of something like 2 years. The wife said it's the husband God called. God didn't call her. No, we have women like that. The brother struggled and struggled. Later, they talked to the wife. The wife later went and joined. Less than 2 weeks after the wife has joined, they were going for workers' meeting. And you know, in Nigeria, their workers' meeting will be 7 a.m. And for you to get there by 7, if your house is very far, you can imagine where you would have left the house. Fortunately, on their motorcycle, they were going to the church. One drunkard that was coming from the night party in his jeep ran through the two of them. The wife that was at the back died instantly. After 4 hours, the husband also died. Come and sit here fixed as two ambulances enter the village to bury the husband and the wife.
A week or 2 weeks after, a letter came from Fuller Theological Seminary School of World Mission, the biggest school of world mission in the whole world, that that brother should come and study masters in cross-cultural missions. And I saw the letter still today is unclaimed. Day is coming. Period is coming when your credential will be unseated in the bottom of the box. I did it in Europe. I got it in Nigeria. I went to Cambridge, I went to Oxford, I went to this one. Very soon, that certificate will be useless. Your children cannot use them. And all these our smiling or frowning faces, very soon will become unappealing and unimportant. At that time, your name will now go into honor of history, and archives will lose memory of your existence. I said, do you know that there are some things that are keeping you busy today that in a few years to come, they will not be important? If you want to work for God, please, when you still have that energy, when you have the strength, look at what happened there before that one. Some things that are keeping you today busy today. One of my younger ones, this girl is very, very brilliant. She gained admission to the university at the age of 14 months. And I was looking. But this girl, as brilliant as she is, can spend hours with the mirror. One day I was telling her, mentioning her, and I said, so person, you are wasting your time. So uncle, leave me alone. Leave me alone. I said, I won't leave you alone. I said, leave me alone. I will still be sweet 16 and 60. I said, you, go and check our grandmother. Today, the other scan will be showing who is still interested. The other scan will be showing who is still interested. She's already out of taste. Nobody is winning again. Who wants to marry grandma? Look at it. I said, young man like me, old lady, you will not be young for life. Remember your creator now and put him first. He didn't run there, if it was to be Nigeria or Africa. When suya will no longer have that taste, suya sports. I don't know what you call it here.
Barbecue.
Barbecue, okay. When alcohol will lose all the appeal. And wrinkles will exchange all these handsome and beautiful faces I am looking at. And the strength to chase girls will fade away. Today, when you look at our teenagers, the youth, they will tell you there is no distance. Distance is no barrier to the lovers. Very soon, you will see that distance can constitute barrier. I said, prepare. I said, soonest, tonic and perfume will no longer enhance your facial quality. Go anywhere to buy them. And this youthful attraction will no longer distract. Today, you will see some sisters. When they are going, brothers will look at their back until they stumble on chairs. Very soon, you will pass. Nobody will take notice of you. Why? Because the most beautiful ones are not here. Prepare jogging and running with some head. And you also join the old people's choir. Singing what sings. Eh? No worry in life. See grandma here now. If they want I and grandma to run, it will take miracle for her to win.